Hello there, everyone, and welcome back. I think it's time to get ourselves prepared. Prepare to go over to Alpha Uxor. For my fuel reserves are completely maxed out, we have ourselves a fairly competent fleet roster available to us here. We have two graspers, two actual Rohibte defenders. We'll just go with that for now and pray that I got it right. And, of course, a handful of Taiwan to escort us. So I think I'm as ready as I could be, although obviously I can always wait until I get more upgrades if I really am that scared about it. Only thing to know is maybe there's a little bit of damage on the Terran Soul I didn't realize, but I don't ever plan on feeling this unless I absolutely feel like it's going to be needed for a situation. Whatever that may be, I might have to upgrade the nukes before that even becomes a thing, since the limited range and the limited tracking is a big hindrance, as we found out against the Kasaki earlier. But let's get to start. We basically repopulate the crew of the main ships that matter. And I think I'm going to use Defenders, that's what I'm going to call them, the dang thing with the tractor can. Although it might get confusing with the Taiwan also being considered a Defender. So hopefully, I'm not confusing anyone when I decide to reference them as the Defenders from here on out, as opposed to Rohidbe? Oh god, it's happening again, isn't it? I said I would leave it be and it isn't happening. Nonetheless, we got our work cut out for us. Good enough to know, though, all I have to do is clear out the ships that are kind of like garrisoning the systems if I want to push their territory back. Although, once we get to a system that has a occupied colony, that might be a lot more complicated, let alone maybe even impossible. Although, we've seen with LaSeal 8760, that can be infected just by having a garrison there. And I think, for good measure, I should just waypoint these territories, at least make it easier to find them. I could also name them, but I think color coding would be easy enough. Blue, of course, for the McKay, yellow for the Taiwan. And hopefully, we're not going to suffer horribly by going to the heart of the enemy, as it were. Well, that's not entirely true. Look how fast this territory is. I'm pretty certain this wasn't as big beforehand, so they really have gotten their birth control. They really are in need of birth control, is what I was going to say. I just couldn't figure out a witty way to phrase it. Oh well. Let's just avoid the dang ships that are in the system, ideally. And hell, once they do realize I'm here, maybe I might have such a lead. I might have such a lead ahead of them they can't catch up. And thankfully, that went without a hitch. We burnt maybe about a third of my fuel reserves, so that's important to note. For I'm pretty certain this circle here actually indicates how far I can travel, which is gonna suck since I think that's the max distance, not like the distance I can travel before safely returning to somewhere I can refuel. That is something I need to be careful of. Thankfully, Alpha Uxor is well within half the reach, so I don't think there's any concern yet, although we do have hostile ships in the area, most of which are with the Drekten, I'm gonna assume. Although confrontation is inevitable, and I don't even know what this ship is. Oh god, it's coming right at us. It's apparently an anvil. Well, we're in their territory. Let's see if we get some unique dialogue with them. Maybe they'll be friendly?
Hot garbage, human vessel!
Nope, I guess not.
We have received orders to destroy you, and would kindly appreciate if you assisted in this matter.
I think it's a safe assumption we're not going to do that. We'll just be going. Well, there's no option to just go. There's no option to power the phasers, as it were, huh? Or even arm the photon torpedoes. We're just gonna try and see if we can get going.
No, you won't do it, scum.
We have. Do you want me to take that ear off of you?
All vessels crewed by aliens with two ears.
Let's get this over with. Can we go without fighting? No.
Uninteresting idea. Our orders do not normally permit such a thing.
Well, at least he's considering it.
Of course, I could make an exception.
That would be nice.
Except our orders do not permit exceptions.
Oh, that's a shame. You had my hopes up and everything.
You die now.
I'd like to see you try, buddy. I'd like to see you try. Oh, there's two ships here. I have no idea what to expect from these, aside for like the bigger ones being like carrier ships. I don't know. Since we're kind of going blind, let's go with what we have the most plentiful amount of ships in, which really is just one extra ship in the Taiwan. So this has a plasma shot, so it's just a generic ship. Ooh, extra crew points is always warranted. Oop. I gotta remember, plasma field drains my energy. Thankfully, it doesn't do anything else that's terrifying. Now, let me charge up the drone, since really, my range on my main gun is horrible for this kind of fight. Are we gonna get the hits in? Nope, they're just grabbing the crew. We'll use it as a bait point. Try and get... Yeah, that thing, I'm pretty certain that thing has more range than I do. But it could be because I'm flying away from them too, to be fair. That's something I hadn't really considered as momentum as a factor. But have fun getting through that while I go charge up. Sure, fly through your wormhole. I'm just gonna get these permit buffs for the rest of the fight. Well, you have to deal with the turret yet again. Thanks for that. You're a real pal. This is kind of like the laziest way to try and fight, but I think we've seen firsthand my predicament trying to fight straight up. Unless I'm willing to suffer permanent damage, which I'm sure you can forgive me for not wanting to go through that, if at all possible. Every ship we lose is well felt, especially for this long-range endeavor we're doing. Did we get any hits in? We got a hit. Oh god, that's... I should have paid attention to what your weapon was, a beam carver, so keep out of range of you. It's going to be tricky to get an actual attack running with that said, since I'm always trying to avoid, evade, and when I fly in close, that's probably a death sentence. Ooh, got a good hit there at least, while avoiding the carver. Can we do it again though? Well, if you could keep... Ah, dang it, the drones had to run out of power at the inconvenient time. Oh, perfect strafing run there. Well, we're starting to get the hang. Oh god. Evasive maneuvers. We're getting shot. We're getting chased in the ass by a zealot. Good god, even the Protoss are here too, aren't they? Why am I hailing? I already know this is gonna go bad. We're being well known here. Maybe I should have just fired Will. It just seems like the wrong route I want to go.
You won't do. We have orders to be the doom of all vessels crewed by what? Aliens with two ears.
Since I can't quite remember, what do our ears have to do with anything?
Who are we to say?
I'm pretty sure I asked this already.
We're just following orders.
And, of course, the obvious question is why are they attacking the Mukai? I brought that up before, too. This time we're facing off against three ships. Well, we know the Taiwan were pretty good for this, if I play slow and cautious. Maybe the most boring way to go, but... And this one has a scout laser, which I'm not sure what that is exactly. Oh, it's probably like a scout rifle, is it? Long-range type of sniper, pseudo-sniper weapon? Yeah, gotta be careful about that. So is the right strategy to get in close? Oh god, an asteroid belt destroyed my drone, ow! How dare you shoot me in the ass? I don't take kindly to that. Ooh, and thankfully it died. I just don't know what killed it, honestly. Since I'm pretty certain I ran out of power before it died. And this thing? Self-destruct. Oh, it is. Oh god. Please stay away from me. Please do not even think about getting close to me. Now I have a lot of incentive not to get close to this thing or even try to attack it. It's going to be really tricky to do, with that said. This thing's got a lot of mobility. Ow. Thankfully, I don't think that hit us, but I think that was the self-destruction taking effect there. And this one has a plasma shot, which is similar to my weapon, I think. It's hard to say since my Taiwan bolt, it's completely named differently. Oh, he's trying to do a flanking maneuver. Don't let him have it. No, it's very similar, but not quite. A little bit slower rate of fire, but ooh, perfect. He flew into our trap. Now let's get the strafer run in and Foy gain hit. Ow. I took a hit, but I think it was worth the trade. We're getting good resources out of it at least, but always tenuous. I want to avoid as many of these confrontations as possible. Where are you, Alpha Uxor? Right in front of us. We're almost to our objective and we're being chased. We may have to fight our way through all these ships if we want to get to the homeworld. So this, I am willing to admit now, this may have been the dumbest strategy. Trying to go to the homeworld, which involves basically destroying every single fleet that's here. And why the hell are there Taiwan? Is there something I'm missing? I hope they're friendly? That's all I have to say. I'm just gonna hail maybe there's gonna be new dialogue for being in their homeworld. Probably
attention!
Not.
Stop your garbage
nope.
Vessel where it is.
Guess not.
You, we have orders to be the doom of all.
Well.
The talking part is always the worst part of the five.
I disagree. It's been working out well. We got some valuable intel, and this time it is the carrier ship. Which terrifies me going with the Grasper. This thing should be big enough and slow enough that I can reliably get grabs on it, but since it's launching fighters, those things should theoretically be able to harass me and swarm me really quickly. Let's go with the Defender. Something a little bit different to mix it up. Especially with this perfect positioning, I've kind of ruined it a tiny bit. Maybe with... Yeah, they are really slow to turn, so maybe the Mookay would have been not bad. I need a good strafe run. In all honesty, oh god. Are these? I hope these things expire at some point, because this is not very pleasant if they're just going to keep building up. My thought process was maybe to build up some acceleration, but that doesn't look like a good strategy. That worked beautifully still, though. Good god. I want to attack from the side, since that's all the attacks were coming from the front. And thankfully, that did not bite me in the ass too much, but why the hell are the Taiwom here? I'm really confused what's going on. I just want to hail the Taiwom just to get maybe some idea what's going on. I don't think the Drekton carrier is going to oblige me, because it's coming right for me now, and I could almost it was going slow enough I could almost evade it. The Grasper has amazing mobility, so maybe... Ooh, yeah, the Grasper might be a good hard counter to the Interceptors, since that's what the oil spill effect's supposed to do. It destroys projectiles that fly through it. It's going to take a little experimentation, mind you, but the maneuverability is alone probably going to be worth it to hit this thing at a good angle. I just got to make sure I'm not flying straight at it. It's the problem. And that makes it a little bit difficult. There. Ah. Oh, it did it took a lot of damage just for flying through that oil spill still. Not intended, but I'm gonna brag as it was. Oh god. And I think those things stopped my mobility too. Oh boy. This is... Oh, it doesn't destroy those projectiles though. So it just damages and destroys whatever can be destroyed, I suppose. Which is convenient for me. And it forces them to take evasive maneuvers. Perfect. Not quite flawless, because again, I was kind of directly in front of it, which means it could have shot me during that time. But pretty damn effective nonetheless. Now please, Taiwom, can you explain what the hell's going on here? No, don't run away from me! I think they're camera shy. They know I'm recording right now. Oh my. Well, since we're at this homeworld, let's go check, see what they have to say. What the hell's going on? See?
Rock! A garbage vessel approaches Drekton Command!
Oh, I was expecting someone different, maybe.
Oh, it is the garbage vessel which destroyed our ships and rescued the earless squids!
Ooh, you remember us.
We hate you!
Aww. I came over here to say hello and try and help you. Sorry about your loss.
Losing ships is bad, but it is what we do. Failing to follow orders is worse.
Yeah, I kind of...
But this is only a setback. The Drekton program for galactic improvement will never be stopped.
Galactic improvement? Last I checked, you're committing kamikaze with reckless abandon. We're still not 100% sure why you were killing those squids. They don't have 2 ears.
That is simple. The squids do not have 3 ears.
I hear a contradiction.
The orders laid out in the Drekton program for galactic improvement are very clear. Beings with more or less than 3 ears must be destroyed. Now then, is there anything else you desire before your destruction?
But what I've been told all this time was that the 2 ears was the crime. What about the scribe then? Good god, they don't have 3 ears. Make up your damn minds, you liars. I don't suppose you'd be interested in allying with us. We have questions. They don't have protocol for this. It worked the first time. It'll work again, right?
Rock, the 2-ear one wishes to improve themselves by learning our three-eared ways. This is commendable. We will spew our knowledge upon thee.
Now tell me, is that third ear detachable? Will we be able to speak on equal terms? What's all this business about ears? Tell us about your relationship. Well, we kind of already know that to a vague extent, but let's jog our memory a bit.
They are our masters and send us to our deaths very frequently.
I gathered that much.
They often send the measured to send us to our deaths.
Ooh, the measured, huh?
The scribe themselves are too busy these days to actually talk to us much.
Yeah, sounds like you're kind of slaves a little bit. Just a tiny bit. How do we help you is the big question. I wasn't realistically expecting to be able to solve their problem overnight since they are kind of in the middle of the scribe territory. But we are going to get information about the measured.
The measured are also servants of the scribe. They are an intelligent reef and are our friends and aid us.
Well, that's another contradiction.
We return the sentiment. The measured are irritating. They speak in forms, copies of forms.
Hmm.
It is frustrating.
I bet. Where can we find them?
Rock, Delta Domos.
Probably too far for us if I had to guess. Do you know who's fighting the scribe? That would be an interesting question, since after all, they're the ones, they're kind of doing the grunt work to a vague extent.
The scribe have told us many times there is no fighting.
Really? Then what were you doing?
They also told us many times not to call them so much. We bet it was those treacherous famished.
Huh.
We will be their doom.
Who are the famished? Where can we find these famished?
Rock. We don't know.
Oh, you're not helpful at all.
The scribe have ordered us not to talk to the other ward species so much. It distresses them.
Yeah, because they might form a federation or something, right? A federation of one. Let's see. We've got some information at least, but what else can we talk to them about?
Rock!
What's this about the ears again?
The scribe are very busy removing bad aliens from the galaxy. Often they instruct us to help. The drinking program for galactic improvement is the key directive we have been given for pursuing this. It clearly states that we should filter aliens out of existence based on ear quantity. Anyone with more or less than 3 ears has to go.
So that technically means the scribe get to go, right? But you only have 2 ears yourself. That's what I'm saying. The cert is clearly a fake. Should we put on a fake third ear in that case? Will that actually work? Who else are you removing from existence? Let's see. I'm just curious why a scribe would come up with something so convoluted. Something so weird. Should...
Questioning orders from the scribe is not allowed. We are to follow their orders and then keep following them until we die.
Which is pretty soon.
Then repeat. If you want to question orders, which you are not allowed to do, you can ask the scribe yourself.
Oh, I tried.
The man who gave us this order has commandeered a lone Menkmax ship in the Epsilon Fatum system.
Huh.
Which is an unusual place to deliver orders, but questioning that is also not allowed.
Interesting.
For us, we will continue eliminating non-3-eared species until we receive orders to stop.
The plot thickens. So, while we have an objective to go visit the Menkmax at some point, I just don't think I can reach that far just yet, though. So what about your fake ear? Please indulge us.
The drinking program for galactic improvement clearly states that we should not discuss our own ears.
Very sensitive topic.
All the great expense with which we have procured them.
Where have you procured the ears from? Please tell.
We cannot talk about it. The ear is real. Go away.
I don't buy that for a second. I'm sure you don't either. Oh my. Who else are you removing from existence? We basically kind of already asked that.
There's you. You're an abomination.
Aw, I'm offended.
You and are your doom.
I'm offended.
We attack the Muke. They have no ears. Or they have too many ears. It is hard to tell because they are squids. Whatever the case, we are their doom. And then there are the Trandals.
Ooh.
We cannot count their ears, so they are a probable abomination. We were also killing the Menkmak for a time. They had two ears like you. Then they had a third ear, so the killing ended.
I'm sensing a connection. Why can't you count the Trandals ears? So many questions, so little time.
They are strange beings with unusual heads. They will not identify their ears, so we destroy them to be safe.
Yeesh.
They gave us little devices once, but the devices gave us many orders, which is not allowed.
So people tried to manipulate
you. You can find them in the direction of the Corpus Cluster.
At least we're getting a lot of different directions we can go to for later on. Now tell us about the Menkmak and their third ear.
The Drenkin Program for Galactic Improvement clearly states that we should not discuss the Menkmak and their ear situation either.
Figures. It almost sounds like the Menkmak are responsible for these orders. That's what it's looking like. Do the scribe have three ears? Please indulge. The Galactic Improvement clearly does not state blah blah blah.
They wear rat clothes which conceal their ears from us.
So you killed them.
The Drenkin Program for Galactic Improvement clearly states that they have three ears, though.
Really? What if they didn't? What if they didn't? Please indulge.
You're suggesting there might be an ethical dilemma under which we might be convinced to kill the scribe?
Yes.
But we are not morons. We follow orders, the most critical of which is, don't kill the scribe!
At least the scribe came prepared, didn't they? That was worth a try.
Rock.
Yeah, I think that's all we can ask, sadly.
Rock.
We got a lot of information, though. That's enough of questions. Let's see about this imminent demise that we're about to get.
Is there anything else you desire before your destruction?
Well, right now you have no ships. I don't suppose you'd be interesting. Well, he just told us no, but we're going to try it anyway.
You do not suppose correctly. We fight for the scribe, which mostly means we die for the scribe. This was a dumb thing to ask. You are dumb.
I guess it's true. Feel free to laugh at me. But hey, they're the ones saying they were terrified, they're remorseful. I figured they would be willing to break protocol, right? I wonder what's making them so strict on protocol anyway.
You won't be going anywhere alive, two-eared scum.
Ooh, try me. Bring it on. No neck. Oh, are we really gonna do insults?
Rock, no! Then you will also be stationary.
Oh, I'm sure the engines could still go. Oh, they actually do have a ship. What the hell is that? Should I be worried? We'll go safe with the Taiwan. Boarding party rear missile. Oh my god, they got a fart missile. They got a butt missile. Where's the Spathy where you need him? This thing's truly trying to infringe on their turf and their playstyle. Gotta be mindful of these boarding parties though. This thing looks vicious. But if it has a rear missile, how the hell am I gonna engage with that said? This is making it a little bit difficult, and now it got more acceleration with that said. Well, at least I hit that thing. Take the hits. Oh god. Oh, thank you, satellite little drone, for blocking the shot for me. That would have been painful, I'm sure. Did that hit? I don't know if that actually hit or not. But at least the drones are actually helping. I don't think the AI is actually targeting the drones, mind you, or the boarding parties, but it is working out. This is going to be tricky. Those things look terrifying since they're a lot bigger than the Drenkin fighter suite. Oh god! It's a nuke! It's a damn nuke! It nearly hit me! The last insult I need is to be killed by a fart missile, or what, fart torpedo? Or butt torpedo? What the hell was the Spathy weapon called again? I know it's an abbreviation, but I forget what the hell the damn thing was truly called. This thing is terrifying, and it's just running from me all day too. Which probably works in my favor. Ah! I got hit by a boarding party! Good God, that thing hurt. Maybe I really should have got the dang. Was it Mukay to kind of intercept? That would have helped a ton here. And at least I have an easy way to deal with the dang fighters. I don't want to go in the gas cloud. Thank you. Alright, I think we're done here, sadly. But we got ourselves some intel. Ooh, the Drentals are way back here. We have the measured surprisingly close. We have reason to go over to the Mechmac. But again, we don't quite have the reach just yet. And is this more the scribe territory over here? I'm assuming so. So I'd like to say we got some progress done. Now let's get the hell out of here. Still, I want to talk to Taiwom. I also am kind of tempted to harvest resources, but the more time we spend here, the more trouble we get into. Please, Taiwom, let me at least... Oh no, I didn't want to go into planet, but now I'm persuaded to. Oh, it's hostile. Wait, why won't you tell me that... Okay. Yeah, half a death a second. I don't want to do that. I want to talk to Taiwom and understand why the hell they're here. Well, technically, they are kind of subordinate of the scribe, aren't they now? But please tell me what's going on. I'm confused. Are you friend? Are you foe? Are you here to help me? Can I recruit you to the fleet? There's an ersatz. Please indulge us with your reasoning for being here. I know we've kind of brought an invasion force, but an invasion wasn't really what we had planned, if I were to be honest.
It's our good friends, the humans.
Now tell us why you're
What's
here.
Up, good friends?
You're not going to answer that question, are you? We're more allies than friends, so yeah. I saw we were best friends, yeah. Something suspicious.
We've been reading a book on how to act cooler.
Oh.
Seeming less desperate. That kind of thing.
Oh, that explains
Want
something.
To hang out and read it with us?
I think I'll pass, but you had me paranoid for a moment there. With the change of your tone, but can we board your ship since it's kind of... You're kind of doomed to get shot down in this territory.
Really?
Yeah?
We kind of need all these ships, so no. Let's go with no.
Okay.
See you later,
it would have been nice to get more ships. Oh god, we're being hailed. Quick, Taiwom, support me. What better way to have this Taiwom support me than to pick one of their ships? Although, let's see, this is a teeny tiny one, so I think the Taiwom are still the right choice. Triple bolt and a canister mine. Well, I'm not... At least we're getting a good variety of ships. I just don't know what to expect from the canister mine. Oh, that explains it. That looks vaguely familiar. But keep shooting it. Keep shooting it point blank range. There's no way you can dodge those shots. That was amazing value out of a drone. That was not so amazing though, trying to shoot it. Come on. At least it forces, if I can be good enough about how the AI is going to react, maybe I can do a counterattack as it tries to evade the drones. Gonna be tricky to do. Oh god, did that hit me? It did hit me. Oh god! Oh, something. That would have been brutal. I was flying directly at that mine too. If I hadn't killed it right then, that would have been really painful. Well, now that the coast is clear, although let's keep in mind, we're still likely gonna get invaded. Let's at least explore a single planet. Oh!
Rock, halt your garbage vessel.
Oh, it's a colony, okay.
It approaches this colony any further.
Alright. Tell us about what your plants actually do, considering you have a lot of cloning going on.
This is one of the delightful colonies of the Drenken. Battle fodder for the glorious Scribe Empire.
That's not quite a title I would be proud of, being battle fodder. I would argue. But then again, I'm not a Klingon. Or anyone that loves battle. What do you do here?
Rock. Make new Drenken. Put them on ships that go into battle.
Okay, so self-explanatory.
Repeat.
Well, that sounds boring.
Normal colony activities.
That doesn't seem normal. I would argue.
Yes, two-eared scum. Take your garbage vessel.
Oh, well, at least he's not going to shoot me. But help is likely to arrive soon. Did we really accomplish anything? It certainly doesn't feel like it, but I am really tempted to go visit the Mechmac at some point soon. Again, we need upgrades. So I'm going to need an additional upgrade to my fuel reserves and a handful of supplies to kind of pay for the trip if I'm going to warrant it. It might be more realistic to go over here, but I forget which one's the homeworld, so I may have to check that. Oh, Delta Corvus might be the one? Where does it say? Does it say anywhere at all? Question the Phasmid homeworld, find out how they successfully fought. We don't even know where the homeworld is just yet. Let's see, Delta Horos. I'm trying to figure out some... Make contact. Nah, it doesn't really want to tell me here what the homeworlds are. I figured it would update me there. Maybe I just missed it. At least we know where the territory is. So that's a start. We can work from there. Ooh, Senate, can I go explore a planet? Nope. I just went to warp sideways. Don't ask me how that works. Hey, we got plenty of fuel reserves. Let's just get the hell out of here before we start actually losing ships, mind you. Since that's going to be a costly proposition. Is there anywhere I can stop on the meantime? Well, it's going to be kind of close. I think I want to make a detour to maybe one of these planets. Or at least over in that area, maybe. If I'm lucky enough, I'll find one of those star bases that I can refuel at. Make a little bit of detour and explore a little bit more as a bonus. Try to anyway. Since we already kind of explored this one planet here. Capitireme, oh god, we're drifting right into it. So that was not all what I had planned. Yeah, well, let's get the hell out of here quickly before help or enemies arrive, before the scribes show up. Since I don't think we're going to encounter any more Drakten anymore, I'm hoping. We're now down to about a third of our reserves, though, so we're going to have to be quick with this. Don't waste too much time trying to explore. Arandi A, what do you have for us? It seems like a small system, so it should be pretty quick. Since I kind of did not consider I'm actually burning fuel. Oh god, they're coming in here hot. Good god. And they're scribes, so... I want hail, but I doubt it's going to be any different. Might as well try. See if they'll accommodate us, humor us, tell us about the Drakten. Since after all, didn't they say they'd take it up with the scribe themselves? Maybe there'll be a chat option available for us.
A surprisingly sturdy human vessel approaches. I cannot tell you how delighted I am that I
Good luck.
Will be the one who claims the honor of destroying you.
Good luck with that. Hey, why did you tell Drakten to wipe out species with two ears? I think I know the thought process here.
Ridiculous. You are ridiculous creatures to even conceive of such an idea. And you have met the Drakten?
Yep.
And survived the experience?
Multiple times.
We shall have to discipline them for this failure.
Oh, you're gonna be dead pretty soon.
Our affairs with our own species are no concern of yours, Savage.
So that confirms my theory. There is something else going on here. Someone's manipulating the other races there, or at least the Drakten. And I think I know where I want to go next. It's just going to require a little bit of upgrading. Now let's deal with this guy before he goes spread the news. It would have been smart for you to run. You should have ran. Oh, two ships here too. I am eventually going to start running out of Taiwan ships. And the Mukhei, are the Mukhei going to be good for things so mobile? They have good turning speed, but how the hell are they going to grab anything? We've seen how fast that interceptor alone was, good god. This may be a mistake, but at least the oil spill might help some, to kind of force a maneuver. And we could grab some acceleration power-ups in the process. It's only got a simple triple bolt. So maybe I can avoid it relatively well? At least it can't fly right at me, otherwise it's going to have that issue. Yeah, just bait it to come after me. It's the stupidest strategy, since it's the one that got the mobility and speed. Did I hit it? No, I didn't hit it, dammit. No, I still took a hit. I figured maybe the gas cloud could have protected me some. Well, it worked. I may not get reliable grabs, but... The oil spill's paying off nicely. Or ink blob. What is this? Plasma shot and flak cannon, so you might hurt a little bit when I get close. But you're also a speed one, if I had to guess, so catching you is going to be tricky. Oh, please fly into that more. If you would be a dumb AI and fly into it, that would be perfect. You're making it really tricky to consecutively trap you into the oil spill, though. Oop, fly in. Yes, more damage. More damage! Since I'm never going to grapple you in a million years, as try as I might. Just two more pass arounds and this thing might be dead. I tried to grapple and I did it too early. Well, that was a little excessive. Maybe I should just spam the oil more, since that would actually pretty damn effective. More interceptors fire at will, I guess. We got the info we needed. There are two ships, the exact same two ships. Let's keep the Mukai going. I'm actually starting to appreciate their abilities a little bit more. I was a little bit worried. Being a melee type ship, it might have been a little bit too problematic. But the AI might be falling for it. And I could spam it to ridiculous measures too. To make it almost impossible for him to dodge if I do it right. There you go. It's a bit slow, but you have no power. Nom nom nom. I was just practicing my Tyranid right there. It worked out well. Ooh, we get a power up for our efforts. I would have loved if somehow I could have damaged that while I was flying through the wormhole. I don't know if that's actually possible, but it was a tempting idea. But since I kind of missed, I don't think we'll ever know. Come on, fly in there. Oh, did I? Aw, I got excited for a moment. Come on, fly in there. Fly in the oil spill. You jerk. Nom 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 nom. Okay. Bring forth Battlefleet Gothic 2. I am ready with the success of this Grasper. I am ready to eat all the ships. All the little tiny mobile ships at that. Let's quickly explore though. Get the hell out and cash in on all the resources we just got. Oh, there's not a whole lot here, but is there an anomaly? No, just a big tornado. Safe to say, we're not going near that. But let's at least get something. Are there critters? Yeah, there's 64 critters at that. Let's be mindful of a damn worm. I'm still a little bit scarred from that experience. Thankfully, it's only 5 crew. I can't even remember how much the lander was, mind you, and I'd rather not be reminded. At least this will be nice and quick. I still don't know if these critters are going to be hostile or if I take damage if I ram them. So we're going to try our best to avoid them, and I still don't know when, if I should kill them. I'm paranoid there might be some little thing there where I might irritate a faction, but maybe I'm overthinking it, more than likely. Let's go over to Aronde B, or Aronde A2, I suppose is what it's really called, and then we'll head back to Earth. We'll gather our intel, resupply, and we'll plan what I'm gonna do. Maybe I should go and help the Mukai with their colonization efforts, since, again, can't really reach as far as I like with the other two races, I think. The Mechmac and... I forget what the other faction was that's over in the middle of nowhere. But we get more Krypton and a lot of supplies. A lot of other resources I'll happily take. Just don't know what it's going to need most of those for just yet. Since I'm trying to avoid going to all the plants, ideally. And that's where we're most likely going to need these resources I've been gathering that I can't... Or at least it doesn't auto-sell anyway. Get going. Let's grab us some loot. I am hoping for it. It's probably not going to be nearly as much of a payday as when I first came into Trek 10 space, but it's going to be close. I want to argue it's going to be really damn close. And then I'll need to figure out what I should upgrade in the process. Again, I talk a lot about the fuel reserves, but I don't think we're quite there just yet, since I think I'm going to need 2 more fuel. Or was I need to get up to 2,500, I think, to safely and comfortably go up to the Mechmac And that is everything. Perfect. We're done. Let's head back to Earth. Call a wrap and enjoy the spoils of our efforts. Hell, can I even see how much resources I have right now? Well, 9,000, so not anywhere close. I'm pretty certain it was about 1,400, but once I sell a lot of the stuff, that'll be pretty good. I'm hoping anyway. Yeah, we're still at a third of our fuel, so let's make this count. Yeah, we can easily make it to Earth. Even take another detour if we so wish. But I'm content with being enemy territory. We got some info. That's really damn useful to progress the story. It's just a matter of how do we capitalize on it. Really, it tells us something that we at least that I didn't really consider, is that someone's manipulating all the other races. For what benefit, I couldn't tell you, since it seems to go, at least to a vague extent, goes against what the Scribe want to do. Although, the Scribe want to destroy everything, especially us, so it seems true to what they would, at least true to what they would do. But we're here. We're back on Earth. We got Mukay and Taiwan here to welcome us. I just need to figure out what needs repopulating. A lot of the Taiwan ships, the Mukay, are actually perfectly fine considering the circumstances. And the defenders here are going to be repopulated or resupplied easily enough. So let's just head back to Earth. And why does it highlight Mercury again? Is it telling me to go to Mercury? I already know I need like enhanced shieldings if I want to even attempt it, which might be what I do first. Hell, come to think of it, why isn't Earth highlighted properly like with all the other homeworlds of the other factions? That's what I'm curious about, even though it's kind of obvious where we need to go, mind you. I am still curious about that. Let's resupply, let's cash in, and prepare for our next endeavor. It's going to be probably taking a little bit of detour. Like I said, I'm going to need to build up and upgrade quite a bit more. Especially if I want to get the shielding for my landers as well. I'm not going to have the resources I want. Hell, it's like 8,000 resource units, I believe, for the additional 50 fuel. So I don't even think I'm going to get one upgrade after I cash in and do a couple other upgrades. Since I kind of... Do I really want to get the advanced nuke for the Terran Soul? I'm not sure. Since I'm going to try to avoid using that ship, but it's good to have options. Let's trade, let's sell, and I gotta remember my fuel too. That's gonna, and only just under, 10,500. And we burnt 1,000 of it just on fuel. So we're not gonna get that upgrade I want. It's tempting to increase my hyperdrive speed. Speed things along a little bit faster, but where is... And I don't even want these two computers, since we found out the hard way about the AI coordinator. Where's the fuel reserves, though? Where did I buy that? Cargo bay? Deflector? Where was... Oh, it's right here. So never mind, I can't even get more. Well, that puts a hard break on my options. Can I even recruit? Oh, I would have liked to recruit more people, but I don't know what exactly to do. You're for Lander. You update us on the going-ons of the galaxy. So I guess my options are pretty damn limited. We got Lander cans. I want the heat shield. Heat shield's really damn cheap, gotta say. Good God. Oh, well, I could get both of them. I could definitely get both of them. I could get multiples of them, apparently. Now, I gotta really think on this, though. I'm tempted to go to Mercury, explore those plants there that have been causing trouble, but I think I need the toxic resistance too. I guess I'm not gonna get the advanced nuke with that said. Ooh, hypersonic nuke. We don't even need the advanced nuke anymore, we got something better. But good God, look at the price tag on that. Deadly homing nuclear missile using technology pieced together from information left by Alexites. That I definitely want to get, but I guess that makes a decision for me. We are not even touching the advanced nukes. Alright, so that makes things simpler for me. Let's just get the toxic shield. Get another heat shield for good measure. And I could buy one more, but is there anything else I could possibly get? More crew quarters? Oh, I'm just a little bit short. Crew quarters isn't terrible. But again, I don't use this thing enough as is. And so, ooh, enhanced collider, what's this? Resource collection range. That would be convenient. It makes things a little bit faster, mind you, but I think it's more terrain that's in my way. So jump pad, the anti-gravity source, this is what I want. So maybe I go to Mercury and grab that. But that'll be for another time. Anything else, Captain? That'll be for another time.